Hi friends, welcome to Tech ARK IT YouTube channel. My name is Ravi. In this video, we are going to see that how to securely copy the files and directories from one server to another server. So you can, what is the commands you can use or how you can copy the data from one server to another server. That's what we are going to see in this session. Let's begin. So here example say that my environment over here, I just have a server machine which have the IP address is 192.168.2.140, and the another server we have 192.168.2.142 over here. So let's copy some data from here to there and there to here, and how we can do that. So this securely copy the data from one source to another source, you can, you in, if you take a another system, see where you can share the data, directories and access into the remote machine and copy the data, where you have to provide some permissions over there. But here that is not case. You don't need to share any data from that server to this server or mounting over here or copying the data. That's not the case over here. So I just know the username and password of that machine. I can just copy the data from this here to that user's accessible directory. So that's, you can use over here. So in order to do that, you can use SCP. SCP in essence, secure copy from one server to another server, where I would like to use this one. So here I have a file called Linux kernel file. This one I would like to copy from this server to remote server. So this is the source over here. Then the destination you have to specify is that the username. So in this case, I'm just using the root user to copy the files. So because of the permission issues, yes, I would like to use root over here. So the destination server IP address of this server name you have to use 2.42, right? 2.42, and specify the directory where you would like to copy. So I just wanted to copy the data into the root directory itself. So I'm just going to do that, enter and say that. So the, whenever you are doing a first time, the authentication, the fingerprint is going to be authenticated in between the server to server, which means that your server is sending some fingerprint and the fingerprint will be stored on the device. Say that, okay, this is a trusted device. So if you say yes, then the fingerprint will be stored on the known host device. Then it will ask you for the password. So we have to type the remote server password. Then the data is copying over there. So it is around 97 MB of the file, which is copied in 0.02 seconds. Like that, you can use the SCP to copy the data. So like this, if you want to copy a multiple files, example say that I would like to copy the files over here, something like this. So okay, any number of files you can copy from over here to there. So these many files I would like to copy to the remote host and to the remote this location itself. Say this time it will not ask because it's already a known host, and it will ask only the password. You say that, enter the password, then all the files has been copied over there. But I'm saying it's copied, but let's verify going there and see that. Okay, pwd, I'm into the root directory over here. Let's see that. See this, I got the files, demo files and timestamp files, mcli file and Linux kernel file. Like that, you can copy the data from one location to another location. Or example say, if I would like to copy the entire directory itself, I don't want to copy the files. So how we can do from here to there? Let's say that I just would like to copy the this links directory from here to there. You can simply use scp-r and provide the directory name. Okay, directory name over here, and provide the destination path where you'd like to copy. So in similar way, I'd like to copy to the root itself, :/root. You have to specify the directory path over here. Enter and say it will ask you for the password, and enter the password of that machine. Then your directory will be copied to the remote machine. So I can go over here and verify that you got this links directory over here. Like this, you can use the files and directories to copy over here, or in some situations I have a limited bandwidth, I would like to compress the data and send it to the WAN link, and that should be create LS traffic over here. You can do that as well using the capital C, SCP capital C, and provide this file name over here, which you would like to copy from here to there, and provide the destination location where you would like to copy into it. Example, say that I would like to copy into the links. So here maybe you can see that the data will be compressed and sent. So it does not send the entire data in the similar way, it sends the similar data into the compressed format, and it's sending the compressed information over there. So this is how it sends. Example, say if you'd like to limit the bandwidth, or if you'd like to preserve the settings or timestamps, whatever the timestamp the file is created over here. So here example, see that this is my location timestamp and details of this file. But if I go to the destination server over here and see this, it should be different. See this, so it is the root, and the timestamp over here, it is that 10/18/12/208. Okay, but here 10/18/12/208, it should be different. Yes, it should be different. See this, October 4 here, but here it is October 11th, right? So like this, the data difference will be there over there. So this is actually the size, that's why it's not, there's no variation in the size. But here you can see that the timestamp is varies, but I don't want to do that. Actually, I would like to preserve the timestamp, all the stuff. So I just wanted to delete this file from over here, and I will copy the data from server to over here with the exact timestamp, and everything will be preserved in place. SCP, you can use RVP, or you can use the P for preserving the data. And I just wanted to copy the file itself, I will not use R, and copy the direct data from here to there. Example, say that root, and say 192.168.2.42:/root. So enter 123. So your data is copying. Now your data has been copied and exit status was 0, and you can go over here and see that the data would be October 4 and 5/36. You can see, come back over here and see that the same data would be, see this, there is no difference over there and over here. So that's how the preserving your information or the timestamp, all the, you can do that. If you have a limited bandwidth from server to server, or if you'd like to copy the data, you can also use by limiting the data size by typing the -l and say that I would like to limit to the 500 kbps link over here. I just wanted to copy some data from here to remote server, 192.168.2.42:tmp, I would like to copy. Then you can type the password. So the data will be copied in very, very less limitation. You can see this, the data is sending within the 500 kbps line. So that's how you have 100 mbps of line, but you don't want it to use entire the network bandwidth. If you'd like to restrict that bandwidth to particular kbps so that this works very better in terms of, if you have the limited bandwidth from source to destination, you can limit the bandwidth here itself and send the data using that pipeline itself. Okay, see this, it's setting very very limitedly, so that's what we specified over there. That's about it, guys. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned. Please subscribe to the channel for more upcoming videos and courses. Please follow us on social networking sites. If you have any technical related questions, you can ask.